The financial supply chain management is SAP ECC's 5 component, and it will come with several modules. The reason for implementing SAP FSCM is because of the several legacy issues that the customers face during their business. Example, in any AR accounts receivable functionality, they always experience like, you know, the cash that has to come from customers, or that is the payment that they have to receive from the customers, there will be delay because of several internal reasons. That what we call is a day sales outstanding. How to handle, how can we improve the customer collection, all these things will be addressed using FSCM functionality. And second thing is, if you can see the typical business situation where the number of customers goes up in the business, the number of paper invoices are also extremely high, because you would be taking a periodical invoices and send it to customers to know that this is the material that is supplied to them and the payment that they have to make. And certainly there are two things that business will consider. One is the cost that you have to incur for printing the invoice and mailing it to the customer. And second thing is that invoice takes time to reach the customer, and he has to make a payment with, where you can see at least considerably any time between, you know, 4 days to 10 days. By having an FSCM product like Biller Direct, let your customers see the invoices online and make a payment online. Good example is the way that you make a credit card payments. If you just log on to the portal and log on to the portal of your credit card company and see your account, what are the transactions that you involve and what payment you want to do it. That you are able to do it in case of credit card and you know, legacy applications. Similar functionality is provided by SAP, that is called as in a Biller Direct. Your customers can, you know, straight away, they will, there is a different process, how you have to identify the customers, how you will provide user ID and password, how they can log in, when they make a payment within the Biller Direct, how it would be processed, all those things would be discussed in the Biller Direct session. All that, what I mean here is, by having an FSCM component, you can prevent high number of paper invoices. Okay, and the third thing is high cost of invoicing and reconciliation, which also required several people, and it's a time consuming, because you have to get the data from the customers and you have to get the data from your bank, then you have to look into your open items of the customer, account of the customer, you reconcile it, and finally see this, this is the balance that you have, where you send in a customer statement on a periodical basis. As I said, having an FSCM component, you can minimize all this. You can save the time, you can reduce the resources cost, and you can also get the lot of confidence from the customer. Now, because of having an several transactions with your customer, there's every possibility, for whatsoever reason, it may be customer related, or it could be a product related, or it could be our own internal accounting department, may lead to several dispute cases. Okay, so when the disputes are there, then certainly customers will have a lot of concern to make a payment. If the tax related disputes are there, or if the price related disputes are there, the time as well as you know, the disputes that will occur, the customer has to look into his purchase order, he'll look into his invoice, then he will raise concerns, say, this is what I'm not expected at the time of placing the purchase order. You added so and so extra charge, you have added extra taxes, and you, there's a difference of the price, and you know, there's a difference of quality of the material. There could be quite several disputes that will come from the customers. If you don't have a proper mechanism to address those disputes, it may lead to customer dissatisfaction, and there is every possibility that you will lose the customer. So to prevent customer dissatisfaction and resolve the disputes on time, you will, SAP has provided a component called dispute management. Okay, so that will address how efficiently you can receive the customer disputes and how efficiently and quickly you will resolve so that you can retain the customer confidence. And the next point is high number of days to reconcile a disputed invoice. Suppose a customer raises an invoice dispute, if you don't have any proper mechanism, either they call you or they send an email or send a letter stating that these are the issues with the invoice. And from the customer point of view, the day when he raised a dispute, he expects that you will be able to, I mean, your business will be able to resolve within given days. However, if you don't have a proper mechanism of resolving the dispute, that letter, that email has to come to you or to the business. Business, there must be few guys who will be evaluating that, and in turn you will assign it to the concerned person. If the dispute is relating to quality, you will revert that invoices to the quality department. Again, where that paper or email has to get forwarded to the department. If a dispute is relating to taxes, then that has to be forwarded to your finance department. It is a very cumbersome as well as a time consuming to understand the dispute and to reconcile it and to resolve it, those invoice related disputes. So by having an SAP dispute management, most of the disputes are very, very real time. Real time means your customers will have an option to raise a dispute case on the portal using a biller direct. In the biller direct, you have a component called disputes, which it will trigger an alert internally to the business stating that so and so one has created a dispute. Then what the person who receives the dispute will decide it, what type of dispute it is. Then he will reassign through workflow to the concerned department, and he will set up the timeline that this dispute has to be resolved on so and so date. In that way, you'll be able to resolve the disputes very efficiently and quickly. Now again, large amount of uncollected receivables. If you don't have a proper tool or a component, then it would be difficult to the customer. I mean, it would be difficult to your client as well as the finance department or cash department to know which invoice is pending for how many days. I know that there are the systems in place, but the mechanism within the system is supposed to be efficient. I mean, to efficient means, suppose you have customer classification in the business stating these are my premium customers, these are the high value customers, these are the low value customers, these are intercompany customers, and these are my one-time customers. When you have that categorization, your system must also be equally efficient to understand how much money is pending from whom for how many days. If it is a low amount, even if it is pending for 1 month, 2 months, doesn't matter. But if it is a huge amount of invoice that is pending from any customer, more than 1 day outstanding is really matter to the business. Okay, so the business must be in a position to identify which are the huge invoices those are pending, which is important for us to contact the customer in the accounts payable department and remind them, hey, this is the payment that is falling due. It is better to make a payment on time. Otherwise, it may attract interstate or penal charges. Though one way it is giving a hint to the vendor, at the same time, you will also have some information that your customer is going to make a payment within given time. He said that I am going to make a payment tomorrow. It is $50,000 of an invoice. Okay. Similarly, you asked some other customers where he has to pay $20,000. He said, hey, I am also going to pay another $20,000 on my invoices which have fallen due. So you will have some clear visibility from your cash collection perspective, how much payment you are going to get against the pending invoices. In that way, you will also have some prediction, this is the cash that I'm going to get from a customer next couple of days. So that is what I say, large amount of uncollectible receivables, which is the problem with your legacy and inefficient system, can overcome having SAP collections module. That's how the collection management is. The collection management has n number of features where you have collection agents internally to the business, and you will generate a work list and assign the list of the open items that particular cash collector, that cash collection agent has to contact the people and find out who is going to make payment today, who is going to make payment tomorrow, what disputes they have, whether they have received invoice or not. All these things you can track using SAP collection management module. By having that, all your uncollectible receivables can be converted and make it receivables as soon as they fall outstanding. Okay, now the next one is process and systems not integrated with business partners. This is quite possible in the given situation. Like, if some of the customers, they have non-integrated system, and even your business also will have a non-integrated system where there is a delay in, getting the information. By having proper interfaces, by having some systems like credit management, that you will be able to get the real-time integration and the required information. Now, difficulty in predicting the cash flow. If you don't have a proper mechanism, a proper tool or proper system to know that how much cash I have to get it in next 1 week or 15 days, how much I have to make a payment to my vendors, then it would be difficult to know whether I'm running out of the cash or whether I'm having an excess cash. If you have an excess cash, you have two opportunities: either lend it to your internally any of the department or any of the company they need it, and if they have a shortage, then you will go for short-term borrowing, or you can have some other option, calling your vendor that I'm going to make this payment on so and so date. So all these things, inefficient financial supply chain activities led to have an SAP financial supply chain management. Now the second slide that I'm drawing to is business benefit of FSCM. While I was talking about the drawbacks as well as the reason for inefficient FSCM activities, or having are nothing but you're converting into the business benefits by having an FSCM module in the business. It will reduce your payoffs, it will reduce your billing cost, as I said, because of the electronically making the payment, faster balancing of invoices, having a readily available system for your customers. You can balance your accounts with your customers. Improved payment processing. This is because of the real-time payment that you do through a biller direct. And improved exception processing. If you have any exception processing that is delaying your payments, customer payments, or invoice processing, or wrong calculation of interest, all those things, exceptions can also be handled very efficiently. Efficient cash collection. When you go for an individual module like SAP collection management, you will see that what are the advantages of having a collection module? Is it really helpful or not? And particularly the functionality called work list, automatic generation of work list, is really, really very, very efficient way of assigning the, identifying and assigning the customer open items to appropriate collection agents. Honestly speaking, SAP collection, SAP has provided some option to integrate with the third party, like automatic dialer. Automatic dialer means you have an FSCM collection management module. You can, using a third party plugin, system will automatically call the customer. When you put the customer's order of the customer that you need to call today, the dialer will automatically call and connect as soon as the customer receives the phone and connect it back to the collection agent, who in turn is not required to call each and every person manually. Okay, so those are efficient tools, as well as the technology and equipments are available at third party, though they are not available with the SAP, which you can integrate with your SAP collection management module and reduce the time for calling the customers, getting the feedback, and updating the description of the each invoice, when he is going to make a payment, whether he is getting delayed, or whether he has any disputes on the invoices, or if you promise that he will make a payment within 1 week, then you have a mechanism to update in the system customer is said that he is going to make a payment in 1 week, or whether he make a promise that I will make a payment in the next 1 week or 10 days, but I recommend you to call back on so and so date, that is 2 days before. Then you can also make a note in the system, so and so customer has asked you to call back on so and so date. Okay, then what system does is, and 2 days before of the payment that what customer promised, system will bring it up on the system and advise you call this customer. Okay, so these are all the inbuilt mechanism of FSCM collection management. Collaboration with a business partner. Your business partners, you can collaborate it, because this business partner is nothing but your customers or vendors. I'm not sure whether you are able to work on FSCM products, SAP FSCM products, but your customers and vendors and your bankers, you can create them as a business partner. In FSCM, whatever the master data that you are creating is the replica of your ECC6 or SAP. Example, if you have created a customer in SAP R3, then you have a two-way mechanism, that is, created a customer in SAP, system will automatically create a business partner in FSCM. Similarly, when you create a business partner in FSCM, will automatically create a customer in the ECC6, that is an SAP system. So you can do it in both the ways, that what we call is a master data synchronization. It synchronizes both the things. If you update once in FSCM master data, it automatically updates the same values in customer master data. Example, you have updated the address in bank address or business hours or some address change related in FSCM master data, it automatically gets replicated in R3 customers. Okay, so that is how the collaboration with the business partners also is really useful. Tracking up financial posting from order entry to reconciliation. Well, honest to speak, the FSCM functionality, some of the FSCM functionalities, SAP, what it does, if you want to outsource those FSCM functionalities, you can still do that without sharing your, you know, core SAP enterprise application to your third-party vendors. So what we do is, if the people, those are who are there in the backend, without knowing what is happening in R3 application, they'll be able to track the end-to-end business scenarios in FSCM if we give access to them. That's what about your order entry to reconciliation. And reduce transactional cost, absolutely no doubt in this. The transactional cost will considerably will come down because of so-and-so integration of the systems, that is your credit management, collection management, dispute management, as well as your SAP application order to cash cycles. All these things will reduce the cost of each transaction. Since, as I said, if you have in a biller direct module, you don't have to have even send your hard copy to your customers, and customers will be able to see all the transactions posted in SAP through biller direct. Having said that, that it will reduce your the transactional cost, because all of these things will happen in real time and your systems are in sync. Okay, now in-house cash reduces payment transaction cost. Absolutely. See, this one is, this particular statement, that is in-house cash reduces the payment transaction cost, has a lot of definition and a lot of meaning, but I can certainly walk you through when I go to in-house cash module. But very high level, in case, let's take a very good example. In case you have 10 subsidiaries for your corporate, there's a corporate called A, and you have three subsidiaries like X, Y, Z. Tomorrow, or say, maybe sometime, because of the business reasons, X will have excess cash, Y will have under cash, Z always will have a trouble with cash. The reason is, these subsidiaries are located at a different geographical location. Each subsidiary is doing a different type of business. Some are seasonal business, and some are high value transactions. Like that, some each subsidiary is doing a different business. Well, sometimes when they need one subsidiary needed more cash, and the other side, another subsidiary is having excess cash. Having an FSCM in-house cash management, you will have a centralized treasury functions where you will have a visibility of all your subsidiaries' cash flows. One subsidiary is having excess, the other one is having shortage of funds. At treasury, what we do in the corporate side, you get the cash in the name of the corporate treasury and you lend it to your a subsidiary which required the funds. So in that way, your corporate treasury will work like a bank, though it is not real bank. You will have an option like, you know, charging an interest for a needy subsidiary and paying interest to the one who has an excess cash or funds. That is one good example I gave it. And second thing is, all the intercompany receipts and intercompany payments. There is every possibility that within the business, you do intercompany transaction. You make a supplies, you receive the goods, and every month then you do transactions like you have to make a payment, you have to receive a payment. Sometimes you are allowed to do net off if both the subsidiaries are within this country, but there is every possibility some of these are in a different countries. So at the month end, you don't have to do cash flow transactions. Rather than, you can transfer the money, you can transfer, not physical money, you can transfer the cash from one account to another account. At year ending, you can do a settlement. Okay, in that way, all your exchange gain or loss get posted periodically. And any third party payment that you would like to do within that country, that can also be done. You will have both in-house cash as well as house bank. So these functionalities we will see when you go to in-house cash. But the transaction that get posted between the subsidiaries as well as corporate, it happens through IDOCs. Now going to the third slide, what is FSCM? It is set up application that can address virtually every process of your entire OTC cycle. Procurement to pay is not being addressed here in any of the FSCM. It's more focused on customer services. It more focused on customer receivables. It more focused on getting the cash from your customer as far as possible. I mean, doing it more efficiently as far as possible. These are all the advantages of an FSCM. It is set of applications which helps in collection process that I very high level I discussed it in the previous slide. This process starts from maintaining master data and with ends with payment received. So maintaining a master data not necessarily to be in FSCM, it can be in SAP R3 also. Having the functionalities, you can having a functionality like a data synchronization or master data synchronization, you can sync both your FSCM and SAP applications always with the synchronization. You can sync up these two applications because FSCM is not inbuilt SAP, but it's an outside SAP but got integrated through BAPIS. Okay, what systems we need for credit management, what configurations we do, collection, credit, dispute and other things, where we need the portals, that we will discuss during our individual sessions on respective module. Okay. Applications are modular in design, allowing us to configure and deploy individual components to meet our business requirement. It means the modular in design allowing us to configure and deploy individual components means these are separate components which you can deploy it according to the need. It doesn't mean that FSCM you're having, it doesn't mean that all the individual components you have to, all the components you have to put it. You don't have to do that. Look into your business requirement. See that which individual module is working for you, you can deploy that only. Example, some of the system, some of the customers, they have n number of business process as well as applications, and some of them are really efficient and they have been built for years together. Most of those processes are pretty much okay with them and they don't want to involve additional cost by replacing those systems. Example, Some of the customers, their collection process is very, very efficient and now they don't want to go for collection management module. Perfect. But still they can go with FSCM credit management. And if they have any challenges integrating with the several credit management, External credit agencies, if they have challenges with external credit agencies, and if there are several integrations, and if they have a problem with defining the credit limit, and is there a problem in enhancement of credit limit, if there is a time issues and the customers are expecting to do it quickly, that is an enhancement of a credit, if they are looking for immediately without giving, you know, a week days or 10 days time, and if you want to interface with third-party credit agencies like Dun & Bradstreet, and you want to get the credit information about them, and if your system is not capable of handling multiple credit agency information, and if you want to have a real-time integration between your sales process as well as your finance process, and if you have an authorization issues, all these things you can address in credit management, provided if you have implemented only credit management. If you don't have a collection management, that's fine. You can still use a credit management, and collection process can be routed through your collection external system, which is the replacement to collection management module. And if the business has very less customer disputes, then it is not necessary that you have to go for SAP FSCM dispute management. If the number of disputes are more, if you want to track them efficiently, resolve it, then only you will go for SAP dispute management. Again, why I'm talking about this again and again is, as I said, it is not necessary that your business has to implement all the modules, all the FSCM modules. They look into that and evaluate it, and you know, they take a proper step in implementing the respective module. Now coming into the applications included in the FSCM module. As I said, credit collection dispute, we talked about it. Builder Direct also we talked about it, and Innos Cash also we talked about it. Now coming to bank communication management. The bank communication management means, you know, that you have a lockbox functionality, you have an electronic bank statement, and these two things will take care of your processing of incoming payment and reconciling your receivables and payables through electronic bank statement. But there are certain business who always does business with foreign countries, cross-border payments, number of transactions that you send it to the bank. Bank initially said that they'll charge very less, they'll go by the transaction. But once you set up a relationship with your banker, and if you start doing a business, and if your number of transactions goes up, and if your bank, you know, charge on the number of transactions over a period of time, the cost that you make, the cost that you involve with the bank is extremely high. Perhaps you may not seen, but there are some business like PayPal or eBay or some other financial service companies like the insurance companies, who does the business on a daily basis with a huge number of transactions. It is difficult to, or it is and it is, I say it is difficult for the business to meet those transactional costs. For that, what SAP does is, if you have Innos Cash Management, also have a bank communication management, be a member of the SWIFT, and directly you can transact, or you can send all your bank related transactions directly to your customers or vendors bank. Instead of sending it to your banker is talking to the customer or vendor banker and making a payment and doing the process. That mapping is discussed in the bank communication management module. The advantage is, having a bank communication management module with Innos Cash, most of the transactions happens very, very efficiently and in real time, and you can minimize the cost of your transactions. Okay, that is what the bank communication management is. Now coming to cash and liquidity forecasting. The cash and liquidity forecasting is, it is not something new, honestly, in FSCM. It was there in ECC6, cash management, that is being replaced with SAP cash and liquidity management, FSCM product, and it is more or less the same. It looks into the planning level, it looks into the inflow of the cash, it looks into the outgo of the cash, and you can set up that by currency, which currency have to make payment within few months or within few days, whatever the time frame they define. Similarly, what is the cash that we are expecting from the customers in what currency, all those things you can track it, so that you can maintain proper liquidity and you can make commitments to your vendors timely and avoid the penal charges. Now coming to finally the treasury and risk management, this is all about your corporate treasury. They talk about money market, they talk about credit analyzer, they talk about the risk analyzer, they talk about hedging, they talk about your foreign currency evaluation, all these things in treasury and risk management. So this is all about your FSCM products, and the training course goes like this. Credit, collection and disputes go together, and biller direct, in-house cash, bank main communication, cash and liquidity, and treasury and risk management, they will go independently. And most of the business opportunities also, sir, most of the job opportunities also come in the same manner. Generally, the customers who go for credit and collection management, dispute management, are not necessarily have to go for other modules. When you go for implementation, when you go for interviews, when you go for customer location, whenever they talk about credit collection dispute together, which is even SAP also tightly integrated this, and you also have a benefit of having integration with these three. That's the reason most of the customers, they look for a consultant having a skill set combination of credit collection and disputes. In that way, the course is also organized in such a way to discuss these three. And now coming to biller direct, it is not necessary. Most of the customers, they also will have external applications which are already established much prior to SAP Biller Direct. However, there are nowadays some customers, particularly those are in transportation, courier service and other financial services, they are interested to go even the Biller Direct, but they are preferring to have their own customizations. Okay, so if they don't have any applications that integrate with the third party to realize the payment, they are even preferring the Biller Direct. But certainly some challenges will come, like branding issues. And as I talked about Biller Direct, but when you know the Biller Direct, it is recommended to have the knowledge of portal functionality. And technically speaking, you need to have a Java person, because SAP uses the Java engine, as well as most of the back piece application interfaces, those are available in each release. And you have to add them, then you also need to have web server. Then you also need to have integration with your credit card company and so on. Those things we will discuss when you go in Biller Direct. SAP knows cash we already discussed. Bank communication management also we discussed. But most of the companies, except like energy and financial services, they may not prefer to go for in-house cash and bank communication management. There's a shortage of resources in the market, but at the same time, the opportunities are also less at this point. But certainly there will be more and more future for in-house cash with the bank communication management. Remember guys, there is no use of knowing the bank communication management individually, but a combination of in-house cash and bank communication management really makes a perfect consultant to take care of business treasury management. The cash and liquidity, as it discussed, most of the companies, they may not prefer to have cash and liquidity management, because SAP has a very limited functionalities. That is what my experience is. But it's a very easy module to understand cash and liquidity forecasting. If you have an opportunity, you can Google it. The job opportunity for cash and liquidity relatively less, and it is easy to understand. And all that what you have to do is you have to define the planning levels and planning level setups, and it automatically will generate the reports. Now, treasury and risk management, unless otherwise, if you have a good finance background, this module is not recommended, because the terms, the financial terms, the business process, as well as the corporate requirement are entirely different than your day-to-day SAP business. Okay. Now, these are the things that we will, these are the modules that are available in FSCM, and the training will be with the combination as I discussed. These are the other things that we talk about during our training. Business partner functionalities, which I explained, FISG integration, relevant baddies, business add-ons, integration of FISD, sales and distribution, and PA. PA is nothing but process integration, which will keep exchange the data. And at the same time, If you have EHB 5 and above, you may not require FSD XI integration. XI integration happens inside, but we still discuss this how it works. Now then credit engine, credit tools. This is very, very important in case of credit management, because most of the business, they will go for FSCM credit because of this particular engine that is available as a part of SAP FSCM company. What this credit engine does is, it will evaluate the customers in different ways to determine the credit score. The evaluation parameters, like, you know, how long the customer has been into the business, how many employees are there, what is the financial position, and how long he has been with our business, whether we can give more credit, we can give credit limit. You have certain parameters and you put that parameters in the engine, which will define certain credit score. There are certain credit rules also will be there that will also we will discuss during our training.